Hvis jeg sier navnet Mike Pilavachi, hva sier du da?
Ja, da gliser jeg. For det er mange gode minner. For jeg har hørt mange forkynnelser fra han. Men han er leder for Soul Survivor. Det er egentlig en menighet i England. Men har på en måte blitt gjenkjent som en gigantisk ungdomsfestival. Første gang de startet i 1993, da var det nesten 2000 deltakere. Så vokste det og vokste, og ble til 30 000 mennesker. 30 000 ungdommer som samles for å høre evangeliet. Og Mike Pilavachi, han har samarbeidet med Matt Redman og Nikki Gumbel, og er en anerkjent person over hele verden. Og han kom til bitte lille Norge, og til en liten menighet som hadde et ungdomsarrangement utenfor Bergen på Hyllestad. Og jeg spurte han hvordan det var for han som pleide å snakke til tusenvis av mennesker å komme til et sånt lite sted som dette.
Jesus so often left the crowd to minister to the one. And if he's our Lord and Savior and our leader and our example, then it'd be a bit bad if we never left the crowd to minister to the one. But it's a joy doing it. I've met some great kids and some wonderful leaders that I hope I'll be in touch with for a long time.
When you look at this generation growing up, what do you see that they need?
Oh, it's what they've always needed, to be honest, in one sense. I mean, every generation, the culture's a bit different, but the people are the same. So they need to know that they're loved by God unconditionally, that he is not only there, but he cares, that there is a purpose for their life, that they're not just an accident, and that God never gives up on them. So many of this generation live with secret shame, and it's the Instagram generation where you put your best view of yourself forward, your best photos. No one tweets, "I've had an average day today," you know? And so when you do that, you start to wonder, if they knew what I was really like, would they still love me? Will they still accept me? Or would they despise me? And so many of this generation are secretly in that place. I talk to them, I listen to them, I know that. And the good news of the gospel is that God knows, the one who knows you the most, knows you the best, loves you the most. And that's wonderful. And not only does the one who knows you the best love you the most, but we, his church, are also committed to you through thick and thin, in the good days, in the bad days, in the successes and the failures. And we want them to, they need to know that. They need to know that they belong, not on based on their performance, but on who they were created to be.
What do you think we can do as churches to reach out to our teenagers on the streets?
Oh, I think it's creating communities of love and acceptance and joy, but also where there's honesty, where people can be honest about their vulnerabilities, about their anxieties, about their failures, about their sins. So when you create those communities, honestly, young people get drawn. They get drawn to communities like that. Yes, we need to go out because that's where they are. They won't just pop up. But we need to have something to bring them to. There's no point going out and finding them if there's nowhere to bring them. You have to bring them to a church that represents the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, to a church that is community. And that's what we have to build. And we have to build a church that reflects Jesus, our Savior, that reflects the Godhead. And it's not us that builds, Jesus builds his church. But we need to become that church. And that means being a church that puts a high value on relationships. This generation are incredibly lonely when you go beyond the mask. Because it's a mask, there's a deep loneliness there. And we were built to belong. We were built for community. We were built for family. And church has a great opportunity to be that family for this generation. I believe that with all my heart.
You used to be an accountant. And today you're recognized all over the world as one who gathers teenagers and bring them to Jesus. And you're also famous for your funny jokes. How did you ever think that you would travel the world like this?
No, I didn't. I never thought that. I mean, I was an accountant till I was 29. I wasn't a very good accountant. And all I wanted to do was serve Jesus, but I knew enough not to try and make it happen. And then one day, the pastor of my church, an Anglican church near London, he asked to see me and he said, would you give up your job and be the full-time youth pastor of the church? And I was like a dream come true. I couldn't believe he asked me. And every single step upon the journey has taken me by surprise. Every single time. My constant response is, how on earth did you do that, Lord? How on earth did you do that? And there's nothing for me. I've had such an incredibly happy life in the end. It's not without its sorrows, but joyful life, because I've walked it with Jesus. And there's nothing more wonderful than seeing him do things that you can't do, transform people's lives, take you by surprise. He takes my breath away, because every time it's a revelation of his love. Every single time. Yeah.
Det var Mike Pilavachi, og han var selvfølgelig i Hyllestad i Sogn og Fjordane, men det var Askøy misjonsmenighet utenfor Bergen som inviterte han.